Hey, and welcome to Smart Office, weekly tips and tricks to work around Microsoft Office applications. Today, I will show you something that has to do with Microsoft Word.
How to create a new recipient list for mail merge in Microsoft Word. With Microsoft Word, we can create group letters that contain a standard body text structure and different personal information for each recipient. A feature that is named Mail Merge. As mentioned, Mail Merge uses the following two components. The main document, which contains the text and all the other objects that we want to repeat in each letter or document. The data source, which contains the recipient information, that is, the items that change in each letter. For example, name, address, zip code, and more. All information about a specific recipient in the data source is a single data record. In each record, a single information in the data source, such as the first name or last name, is called a field. In this video, I will describe how to create a new recipient list as a data source. Just watch the video below. I have defined that this is going to be the main document for my mail merge, for the mail merge procedure. Now I want to connect the main document with a data source list. From the area of the ribbon named Start Mail Merge, I select the command Start Recipients, where we can choose the list of people we would like to send your documents to. Now I haven't got any list, any data source, so I'm going to have to type a new list. So I just select the command, type a new list here, title, first name, last name, company name, address line, so many fields inside, which we don't need all of them. So at the bottom of the new address list, we can customize the columns. Here are all the field names available. The title, I do not want it, I select it and I press the delete button. Are you sure? Yes. Address line 2. I don't want it, I press the delete button. Yes. Zip code, I leave it. Home phone, do not want it, delete. Yes. Work phone, delete. Yes. State, city, address line, company name. I'm okay with all of this. I'm gonna rearrange the fields a little bit. So I select the last name, move up. Company name first. If I'm happy with all the results here, how I have arranged the fields, I just press the OK button. And now we can type all the information. Oh, copy. Panagiotidis. Philippos. I move in between fields with a tab button. Alexandrino, Chalkidiki, Greece, 63077, Greece, email address, Again, underneath, System Plus, Spanougakis, Christos, Thessaloniki, Zvolu 25, Thessaloniki, Greece, 555140, Greece, and Chris, System Plus, Telia GR. We can insert as many fields that we want to. Once we have finished creating our data source list, we just press the OK button. Well, we're going to have to save our data source list. So I'm just going to save it on the desktop. I'm going to name it example address list and save. That is it. I've created a new data source list. Now, if we want to edit the data source list before we proceed with a mail merge, we just set the command edit recipient list. Make changes to your recipient list or pick specific people to receive the mailing. Okay, now we can either, this is the list, sort the list. We can either filter the list. We can either find duplicates of the list. We can either find a specific recipient, or we can use the validate feature. And if we want to add another recipient, that just in case we have forgotten, we select the command edit, and here we can create a new entry, and ergo Papadopoulos Yanis Furka Halkidiki Greece 63077 Greece Yanis ergo.gr, and once again press the OK button. Oops. Do you want to update it? Yes, I do. So now we have three recipients in our data source list. If we're happy with the results and finished, we just press the OK button. And now we can proceed further on with the mail merge procedure.
Thank you for watching. If you liked what you saw in this video, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, head down to the comment section and let me know.